marketing mix modeling. The videos I've done on MMM have been some of our most popular, which tells me you want more. And so you should. MMM is now regarded as one of the cornerstones of marketing measurement for 2025 and beyond. If you haven't watched my intro to MMM video, I suggest you start there so you have a foundational understanding of what it is and what it isn't, because both are important. In this video, I'm going to run through the three options you have for implementing MMM and the pros and cons of each of those options. Why are we all so interested in MMM again? Before I dive into how to implement MMM, I just want to touch on the current state of marketing in general and lend a thought on why MMM is having its moment in the spotlight. I'm going to go through this kind of quickly, but there is much more background out there if you are interested. Before new age measurable digital marketing, marketers used to try and understand the effectiveness of their old school marketing like TV and print by creating statistical models. Then, measurable digital marketing came in and click tracking became possible. Using Google Analytics, marketers were able to see who clicked what and when. Then came attribution models, which, for all intents and purposes, allowed the creator to apply an opinionated view of which clicks contributed most to the conversion. But note, the attribution models themselves were not and are not capable of knowing which clicks contributed the most. They simply weight the clicks differently when providing a view of marketing efforts versus conversions, i.e. first touch, last touch, or multi-touch. Although these attribution models never provided a statistical opinion of how your marketing efforts contributed to conversions, they have provided marketers with a framework for how to evaluate their marketing efforts. This framework has received a lot of critique over the years due to its assumption that if an ad click preceded a conversion, then that ad click definitely had some role in causing that conversion. While it's probably not crazy to claim that this relationship exists in most cases, the attribution models can't prove that it does. They're at best correlational. And to add insult to injury, lost access to user-level data due to cookie restrictions and other privacy measures, attribution models now also have a lot less input data. That doesn't mean attribution is going away, but it does mean we need new tools to complement their weaknesses. MMM, together with incrementality testing, are the go-to tools to add to multi-touch attribution to ensure a well-rounded measurement arsenal. Stay tuned for an in-depth video on how best to combine these tools together. What then is marketing mix modeling? At its core, marketing mix modeling is multivariate regression analysis and dates back to the 1960s. The name is originally derived from the four P's of the marketing mix: product, price, place, promotion. But in the context of online marketing, it's mostly concerned with modeling the impact of advertising and is sometimes referred to as media mix modeling. But whereas media mix modeling is typically the effect of media spend, marketing mix modeling is looking at your entire marketing efforts. MMMs use historical data for modeling a dependent variable like sales as a function of independent variables like advertising spend across different media channels, and control variables like seasonality, weather, competitor actions, and more. The output of MMM can then be used to predict how changes to the independent variables can affect the dependent variable. Or, in simpler terms, how one might increase sales by adjusting the marketing mix. Options for implementing MMM. If you want to implement marketing mix modeling in your business, you have three options. One, buy a SaaS tool. Two, hire a consulting firm. And three, use an in-house team. Like with anything, there are pros and cons to each option, and I'm gonna run through each one and show you a nice framework you can use to visualize the differences. Okay, so it's not my best framework ever, but whatever, let's roll with it. First, let me run through the criteria I'm using to evaluate the pros and cons. Like a true consultant, I'm just kidding, I'm not actually a consultant, but I do have some friends who are, and man, do they love a framework. Well, this framework is sort of a cost-benefit analysis that I put together. First, we have flexibility. With flexibility, we're talking about the ability to tailor the model and the processes to your needs as a business. Secondly, we have DIY. I know, listen, we spent way too long trying to come up with the right measure here so that least was always at one end of the scale and most was always at the other. Trust me, it was way harder than it seems. But, well, that means we're left with DIY-ness, but it's essentially how much skill is required to take advantage of MMM with each method. third is speed of delivery. This is the time it takes to get from, I want to do MMM, to, oh cool, that's a useful MMM output that I can actually utilize. Before I dive into measuring each method, I'll just run through the methods themselves so we're clear on what I mean with each categorization. SaaS. Okay, what does this mean in regards to MMM? This isn't like buying a simple project management tool like Notion or Asana. MMM SaaS products are relatively new and there aren't tons of them around. The main reason for this is that up until recently, there wasn't enough wider market demand for MMM tools. Therefore, the market didn't supply tons of solutions. That and how time-consuming data collection can be if those pipelines don't already exist. In short, an MMM software as a service tool is a tool capable of ingesting the data required, running the model, and providing an output, all without the user necessarily needing to have a deep, deep understanding of the technical side of the process. What the user does, however, need is a strong domain knowledge so they can bring the nuance of their setup to the tool. Things like campaign naming conventions, regional splits, or product feeds. Consultancy. I'm sure most people have a sense of what hiring a consultancy in general entails, but hiring a consultancy for MMM would likely look something like the following. Objective setting, data collection, data processing and cleaning, model development, model validation and refinement, insights and analysis, optimization and scenario planning, reporting and recommendations, implementation support, and training and knowledge transfer. That's a nice easy 10. But if you want an in-depth look at how MMM is executed by a consultancy, be sure to check out our video about a real-life MMM case study. In-house. Think data team plus marketing team equals in-house team, possibly capable of implementing MMM. This would be where the in-house team builds MMM capabilities themselves, which is no mean feat. But in short, they need to get hold of the data, prepare it for the model, then feed it into the model that they built, and likely spend a lot of time customizing and tuning the model slash input in order to provide a useful and informative output. But depending if those skill sets already exist in the business, it would be a similar process to a consultancy, but you're paying for it with resources rather than with cash. Now we have the basics of each method down, let's run through the variables we're using to compare the different options. Flexibility. The core strength of SaaS is its plug and play nature. It's more accessible than the other options, but at the cost of degrees of flexibility. A SaaS at its core is a technical platform serving many different customers cost efficiently in a streamlined fashion. SaaS often has a high degree of self-service, making customers free to derive value from the solution independent of the SaaS vendor's working hours and availability. In order to achieve this, the SaaS assumes a certain degree of similarities across customers and their needs. This is usually fine, but in the rare case you find yourself an outlier in terms of your needs, the SaaS route is likely not the right one for you. The consultancy business, on the other hand, is predicated on coming up with bespoke solutions. So, if you have special needs, chances are any good consultancy can probably sort you out. Depending on how complicated your use case is, this will likely be reflected in your invoice, so make sure to set your expectations up front. This stuff ain't cheap. In case you have the skills and experience to pull off an MMM implementation in-house, this option gives you maximum flexibility since you're effectively building your own platform on your own schedule. The question to ask is whether you actually need all that flexibility and what you're choosing not to build by investing in this. Because let's be honest, you can't build everything at once all the time. DIY-ness. If you find yourself with little to no skills with regards to how to implement an MMM, interpret its output or use it for decision making, then the consultancy route is probably right for you. Less do it yourself, more have it done for you. A good consultancy will not only do all the heavy lifting when it comes to building and tuning the model, they will also hold your hand and help you both ask the right questions and put the answers to good use. If you're at the other end of the spectrum and know exactly what you're doing, then the in-house route could be a good fit. It might not be the right one, however. Depending on how flexible you need the solution to be or how unique your demands are, I would also kind of assume that if you find yourself in this camp, this video might not really be for you and you've
already left for Bayesian versus frequentist debate videos on YouTube.
Can you tell I had to get someone else to write that joke for me because like I can't make statistics jokes. That is way beyond my skill set. Thank you very much, Sven. Anyway, lastly, on the topic of skills, if you have some idea of what you're after or if you're not afraid of learning by doing, the SaaS route is probably the one. It gets you up and running the quickest and should come with the lowest price tag. It's also worth noting that most SaaS vendors do provide onboarding services and ongoing help to ensure you're getting value. Although it's not comparable to the white glove experience of your high-end consultancy. Fancy. Speed. One big benefit of a SaaS tool is that they are built to be quicker and easier to use. SaaS tools literally spend their time improving the value a product provides, and so this works in your favor when it comes to MMM. Whereas typically data ingestion requires a lot of data engineering, SaaS tools aim to reduce the time spent in this area and others. Consultants can expedite the process by leveraging their experience and established methodologies, meaning they can offer deliver results faster than an in-house team starting from scratch. But the engagement does typically involve a long project setup phase, which can take weeks or months. If you as a marketer are hiring them, you need to factor in that there's probably going to be a ton of work involved in getting them access to the necessary data in a compatible way. This is no small feat and likely requires a bunch of work from in-house data teams. What I mean by this is that it's unlikely you can hire MMM consultants and keep the project contained within marketing. This data engineering work takes time, and if the project sits outside of the data team, we all know that prioritization could be an issue. Once established, an in-house team, however, can provide ongoing and timely analysis without the delays associated with external implementation. They can also respond quickly to new data and business questions, which is pretty good. Setting up an in-house capability from scratch is the most time-consuming option, though, and recruiting or training staff, setting up processes and developing models can take several months to well over a year, which is a long time to wait for answers to your burning measurement questions. Okay, to summarize, implementing MMM requires five main components: data collection, data normalization slash preparation, creating the initial model, interpreting and acting on the results, and fine-tuning the model. What else? SaaS tools are really strong at providing easy-to-use, out-of-the-box solutions that don't require huge time investments to get to value. They leave you in the driver's seat with a high degree of self-serve. All this at the cost of the ability to cater to some edge cases. Consultancies bring strong MMM knowledge to the table and can hold your hand along the way. But they are comparatively expensive, as you can see in my bonus column, where I use the Google Maps affordability rating for restaurants, giving each method a number of dollar signs depending on how much it will set you back. Building out a marketing mix model in-house requires very specific skills, which, if you don't already have, can take time to develop or even recruit for. It's endlessly flexible, but comes with an alternative cost, along with the need to maintain and support whatever you end up building. Essentially, SaaS is fast, cost-effective, and doesn't require a ton of MMM experience. Consultancies are flexible, require zero prior knowledge, but come at a higher cost. And in-house execution is super flexible, requires deep skill and experience, and comes at a high alternative cost. And that's it for today's video. If you found this video useful, like and subscribe, where you'll get more videos about digital marketing, marketing data analytics and measurement, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to make yourself a better marketer. Bap, think about